Good day, everyone. Once you have decided on the payload and we have integrated the payload with the drone, it is important to keep the payload safe from any damage and maintain the payload under different weather conditions and usage. It is important to take care of your payload because your payload might cost a lot and is a key part of getting all the data and fulfilling your requirements. Recognition of critical failure due to internal malfunction or interaction with an external object or force is a distinctive problem for the payload. Timely detection of critical failures can be used to enable activation of drone recovery system in order to save an aircraft or sensitive data from being destroyed or falling into adversary hands. Therefore, it is important to follow safety precautions and maintenance schedule to take care of your payload. Let us look at the same in our upcoming slides. One of the main things to keep in mind is to make sure our payload is safe in case of failure or during the landing impact of the drone. As we discussed earlier in our lecture, we can do so by making a small protection frame around the payload so that the frame isolates the vibration from the drone as well as absorbs an impact or crash that occurs on the drone. Many times, we can also attach the camera on the gimbal because the gimbal also acts as a safety system for the camera by isolating the vibrations. Therefore, the gimbal not only plays a role of stabilizing the camera, but also acts as a vibration absorber for the payload. In case of critical failure, the autonomous parachute deployment systems are being the primary drone recovery method now. Autonomous emergency systems are responsible for deploying the parachute in case of a critical failure, such as loss of radio control or electrical or engine failure. The main advantage of the parachute-based drone recovery method is that the drone may be retrieved from anytime, anywhere. In addition, if a parachute is used as the primary recovery method, it may also be used as the emergency recovery method, saving additional cost and weight. These systems are designed to safely locate drones in emergency situations. Usually, the drone flies autonomously to a pre-selected site and the parachute is deployed, ensuring safe recovery. Most parachutes are parafoil or cruciform shaped, stored in the drone frame. In cases where external sensitive equipment is under the drone frame, the parachute is deployed from above the drone frame so that it is much more easier and the drone does not lose its stability. A more complicated system for protecting the drone structure or any sensitive parts is the combination of parachute and an inflatable buoy, which is kept under the drone. The buoy also is used to keep the UAV afloat when landing on water. The main problem in the parachute recovery is the transition from a stable drone flight to a parachute flight. Although parachute steering is possible, the oscillatory movement of the drone presents problems in recovery, such as inaccurate point landing or touching it down with a greater impact. This may damage the drone also. So care has to be taken when designing or using a parachute recovery system for a drone. One of the areas that is being focused currently in drones is designing landing gears, as shown in the figure, which can absorb the impact on the landing. As the drone takes multiple takeoffs and landings, the force due to it is faced many times by the drone. And if the drone continuously faces this impact, it is important to isolate the drone and the payload from these forces, which can slowly cause a damage to the payload. This slow damage can suddenly lead to a permanent damage to the payload or the drone. Hence, usage of soft landing pads and shock absorbers is being studied upon so as to absorb the impact damage as much as possible. One of the things that I've faced personally is the payload being hacked by an external entity. Many times we use onboard devices such as Raspberry Pi or so for storing or connectivity of various purposes on that phone. However, these devices are easily hackable and someone can take control of a payload if care is not taken. Also, you have to make sure that any data that is coming from the payload is not remotely saved. This especially happens when we connect the payload to the computer or provide connectivity to the payload, where along with the drone data being given to you, it is also uploaded to a third-party site. So always make sure that your payload is taken from an authentic place so as to avoid any leakage of data. Finally, considering all these parts, once we have attached the payload and taken proper safety precautions and so, we are in a position to attach the payload to the drone and fly the drone. So let's safely attach the payload and fly. Thank you very much.